Yo, what's up guys? All right, so really excited for this video. I know it's gonna help a bunch of you guys out there who are either starting your social media marketing agency or are currently already in the grind, finding clients, delivering results, all that kind of good stuff. What I'm gonna go over is the introvert's guide to prospecting and getting clients for your social media marketing agency. I myself am an introvert, you know, always have been. That's kind of, you know, I guess before even starting my social media marketing agency, I thought that would be, you know, a downside, a disadvantage to all that kind of stuff, because there's this kind of myth that the introvert would do less or would have less success than the extrovert because they're really good at sales, all this kind of stuff, and they're really out there meeting people all the time. And that's just not true. And that's something that I found once I actually started doing outreach, started doing this whole social media marketing agency stuff. And you actually have a great advantage when it comes to getting clients, closing deals, when being an introvert. And I'm gonna show you exactly how to get clients in a way that, you know, doesn't really, I guess, play on your weaknesses too much, but really focuses on your strengths. So if you're an introvert, you probably wouldn't prefer doing like cold calls and all that stuff. I myself actually do cold calls. I like to put myself out there, step outside my comfort zone, that kind of stuff. But what you can do, especially if you're starting out in that kind of stuff, what you can do as an introvert is three different methods of outreach. And what that is, the top one I like is LinkedIn. I mean, LinkedIn right now is the best, I said one of the best ways of getting clients and getting on sales calls. First of all, I mean, that's basically like the Instagram for working professionals, right? So if you're trying to work, like reach out to a business owner, more than likely they're gonna be on LinkedIn. You can reach out to them and set an appointment fairly quickly, all right? So LinkedIn is one option. If you're, you know, really good at it, you can actually set an automation in place so that you don't actually have to physically be sending these LinkedIn messages. And so I actually have a video on that that goes over that. But another thing that you can do is Facebook Messenger. And that's something that's worked extremely well for me. And I would do it very strategically. I wouldn't go specifically for, say for example, just adding or say sending a scripted long form message to a Facebook page. That's gonna get you an automatic ignore. What I would do is I would find the business owner, and then what I would do is I would add them as a friend and then message them directly after they've already accepted. You get a higher reply rate by far. It's day and night. I thought that Facebook Messenger didn't work because, you know, I never got replies, but it was because I was sending messages to the business page. I wasn't adding the owner and adding him as a friend, building that relationship, and then getting on a call. Those end up being a lot more effective than just sending a scripted message to a business page, right? It's even better if you send a video as well. Although it's not required, I've still gotten some good replies with just sending a message, right? So that's another one. First one, LinkedIn. Second, Facebook Messenger, right? Add the owner first, start the conversation, get them on a call. The third one, which is very effective, and a lot of people think it's not, but it just has to be done the right way, is cold email, right? And so with all these things too, I always stress, like when it comes to this kind of outreach, it has to be to a certain niche, right? You can't really automate the process if it's not to a certain niche, right? Because certain language is gonna appeal to them more, and it's gonna let them know that one, it's not automated, and that you actually know their business, right? Same thing with Facebook Messenger. It's better when it's with a niche, although since it's not automated, it could be to different niches. Just really depends on, you know, how you wanna play it out. And with the cold email, with the cold email, it has to be to a niche, right? Because you're sending hundreds and hundreds of these. It has to be speaking to one direct person, specifically to what it is that they desire. Like dentists, they value Invisalign clients, right? They make the most money out of that. Plastic surgeons, they value breast augmentations, right? It's the least I guess, how you say, like the least liable, I guess that's what it's called. Like, they won't get sued as much for it, for that, and it's the easiest thing to do. So if you put that in an email, like, can you take on more breast augmentations, whatever it might be, on cold email, that right there, when sent to maybe 50 or 100 emails per day, is going to be very, very effective. And there's people that I know in the digital marketing community that do extremely well with purely only cold email. I mean, keep in mind all of these things. There's people that are purely only getting their clients through LinkedIn, purely only getting their clients through Facebook Messenger via video, DM, whatever it might be. And there's people that are only doing cold email and absolutely crushing it. So, I mean, the fact is that you no longer have to cold call. And I'm not knocking it, because I do it myself sometimes to get prospects. It's very effective if done right, and if you have the right mentor in place to coach you through it. But if that's just not your cup of tea, then you still have these three different methods for getting in front of clients, right? So there's no excuse. And even for a sales call, if you're an introvert, it means that you listen very well. You have a good way of understanding people and understanding what their needs are, because you're a really good listener. And so that's a huge advantage as compared to maybe an extrovert who might just talk themselves out of a sale sometimes, right? Because it's really more so about 70-80% of you listening, and the majority of the sales should be them talking. So if you're an introvert, I hope this was helpful. I mean, this right here has helped me tremendously. I had that limiting belief saying that, well, when I started out thinking that, man, I'm an introvert, so I'm just at a loss here. Like, I'm starting in the negative here. An extrovert would just kill it at this. And that's just simply not true. Every single one of them have their own advantages. If you're an extrovert, sure, you have some advantages. But if you're an extrovert, you have the advantage, certain obvious advantages, right? Networking and all that kind of stuff, getting out there. If you're an introvert, you have the same amount of advantages as the expert when it comes to absolutely crushing it. And yeah, if you have any questions, DM me on Instagram, leave a comment down below. Let me know if you'd want me to do other sort of stuff regarding introvert related and SMMA related, maybe something on sales or something like that. Let me know. If you like the video, subscribe, comment, like, all that good stuff, and I'll check you guys in the next video.